People have always fought over land and resources. Obviously, environment in many cases was a victim of conflict, but it also was a catalyst and protractor of such conflicts. But increasingly, the environment has another role in conflict: peace building. Focus on the environment can rebuild livelihoods, communities, and economies. Focus on the environment can reintegrate ex-fighters and provide peace dividends. And it can rekindle cooperation and reconciliation along shared resources. So this course explores the many environmental risks linked to conflict, peace, and security. In Iraq, I saw how the horrendous terrorist group called Daesh, or Islamic State, used destruction of the environment as a way to fight the people of Iraq. And in Somalia, I learned how resources like charcoal finance al-Shabaab and how climate change is exacerbating the conflict, moving hundreds of thousands of people into the cities to avoid the drought causing so much hunger in Somalia. This course includes experiences from my own time as a peace mediator in Sri Lanka and some other places. It also builds upon the work of UN Environment to support farmers like Ibrahim Esa to build a water system that protects against shortages and conflict. Ibrahim Esa is living in North Darfur in Sudan, and they have mobilized 20 nearby villages for this great purpose. But there's more to be done. So I want to thank our partners for making it possible to offer the first course of this kind: the Environment Law Institute, Columbia University, Duke University, and the University of California in Irvine. And I want to thank you for taking the time to learn more about these absolutely critical issues. Good luck with the course, and I look forward to listening to your results.